early in the history of this channel, I did a series on rewiring the Singer potted motors that are used on the 201-2 and the 15-91. And anyway, I had used this tool that I had put together rather crudely. This tool will push the brass brush tubes out of the plastic brush holders inside the motor housing. Anyway, this tool is getting kind of long in the tooth. I've dropped it a few times, kind of busted it up a little bit. So I made a new one. Viewer Terry McClean had asked recently if I would be so kind as to share the dimensions of the tool that I made. Now, the brass brush tubes, I'm going to see if you can see this here, they're not perfectly square. They start out life square, then they were slit at the factory, and the material that was removed, it allowed them to kind of pinch these together, and it makes for a nice tight snug fit when the brass tube goes into the plastic brush holder. Now this brush holder is obviously is secured with a set screw into the body of the motor. So what I did, I took the plastic brush tube holder, I used a dial caliper, make sure it's zeroed out. This is not the greatest dial caliper in the world. And I just made some rough measurements, and I came out with about 264 thousandths or so as the distance across the bottoms here, the opening size. So we can go slightly smaller than that, like a thou or so. And what that allows us to do with the holder in place, with the brass tube in place in the holder, we can then put our tool in and press, and it forces the brass tube out. So, we're going to go back to the editing bay. I've got some graphics I've put up, and I'm going to show you how I made this. Now, the material I used for this tool is half-inch thick, ultra-high molecular weight plastic. And the reason I used it, quite frankly, is because I have a whole bunch of it that I inherited from my brother when we closed his shop out. You can do this with hardwood. I would suggest a nice dense hardwood like a maple or one of the tropical hardwoods. If you do that, though, keep in mind it's going to be a little bit more difficult to work. The harder the wood you go, the more difficult it's going to be to work it. The nice thing about ultra high molecular weight plastic is it cuts beautifully with any woodworking tool. It's very strong. You don't have to worry about grain direction. If you're doing this with wood, keep in mind you're going to have to keep the grain going in the length of this. That's why I went plastic. It's so much easier. And I was able to make this entire thing using my normal woodworking bandsaw. Now, like I said, you can do this with hand tools too. This first one I made, I actually did do this with hand tools and a sander. But like I said, I whipped this one together. Long story, but I really cranked this one out really, really fast. I took a little bit more time making this one today. So let's go into the edit suite because I've got some graphics that I put together, and we'll talk about how to make this. Our goal is to leave a protrusion that's slightly heavier than a quarter of an inch square coming out of the middle of our stock. We're going to do this in 8 cuts. The first 4 cuts are going to define that heavy 1/4 inch square stock. These are the first 4 cuts. The first, the second, the third, and the fourth. The 5th through 8th cuts are actually going to give us our final shape. Here's the 5th. The 6th. The 7th, the 8th, and this is what our final product will look like. Pardon my lousy graphic arts capabilities. I'm a sewing machine tech, not a graphic artist. Well, I hope that answers your question. It is a very useful tool. I have never seen anybody else use anything like this. Then again, I don't watch too many people's videos on doing motors because I know how to do them. But I'm sure other guys out there who are doing motors have come up with their own way of extracting the brush tubes from the plastic brush holders, but this is the way I do it. Anyway, if you want to make one, great. Send me pictures of what you come up with, and thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.